Hey guys, this is Senti Reads, and as you can see by the video title, today we will be covering Scottie Part 7. And as a recap from Part 6, Vanessa woke up from her coma just in time for Scottie to give her a hero monologue, and then immediately almost kissed Jordan when Jordan comes over for a sleepover. Ooh, not the best look for our girl! Jason and Scottie then go to Applebee's, where Scottie gets an urgent call that her mom is in the hospital. So she goes, learns that her mom has cancer, and is then, for some reason, hospitalized for having an anxiety attack. Scottie's mom clearly then recognizes that Melanie is pregnant, and we learn that Melanie is going to have a baby girl. So let's see how Part 7 shakes out.
Part 61. Dad's home. Great. He was probably home with Mom again. He looked mad. Obviously got a phone call from school saying I wasn't there. Even if he was mad, it was worth it. Okay, so this is the second time she skipped school. Hi, Scottie Marie. That's just so funny to me. Scottie Marie. I'd like to talk to you in my office. Geez, it sounded like I was his employee about to get fired. Again, why does a police officer have an office? What could he possibly need to do from home? Okay, Dad. I waited for him in his office. He came in with two water bottles and handed me one. This was a little weird. Whenever he wanted to talk or give me a lecture, it was never located in his office, and he never brought me a water. Weird. Yeah, that is weird. He sat down across from me. I know a lot is going on, Scottie, but don't let it take away from your schooling. Yeah, the school called him, and he has no idea what I am through, besides the little bits and pieces he is going through as well. Yeah, the school called him, and he has no idea what I am through, besides the little pieces, bits and pieces he is going through as well. What a terrible sentence. I know you ditched school today, and I don't think anything is more important than school. I want you to know that school should be your main priority. Typical lecture. You have a life ahead of you, Scottie, and a wonderful school. Take advantage of that. Well, I'm assuming she goes to public school, and we all know how that is. I wouldn't exactly call that wonderful. I didn't know what to say, so I nodded slowly. I'd also like to apologize, he said. For what? I thought. Me and your mother should have told you about her having cancer. He had tears in his eyes as well as I. It's just hard for your mother. Her and I both thought that she can get... She can... What? Her and I both thought that she can, through chemo, then get better without you and your sister knowing. Okay, so when her mother fainted earlier, her parents already knew that she had cancer and just chose not to tell them? Because that's like a really fucked up thing to do to your kids, because chemo is really rough. You're going to lose weight. You're going to lose your hair. You're going to look sickly. So how would they not notice that she's been going through chemo? That's what I want to know. I understand, I said quietly but assuring. How long has she had cancer? We found out about a month and a half ago. Wow, she hit it well. I knew nothing really about cancer, but I knew you died from it. Well, not always, and I'm not going to comment on Amber Lynn's cancer. Let's try to avoid that, guys, in the comments. Let's not talk about Amber Lynn's cancer. Let's just leave that be. She has a tumor in her stomach. Chemo will help her, but it doesn't work for everybody. You could literally tell he was choking up inside. Literally? You can literally tell. Again, don't use the word literally when you're writing. Because if you're writing it, then it is literal. You don't need to say it's literal. All of this was shocking still. Dad, everything will be fine, I promise. I didn't know if I should be the one comforting him, but it made me feel good that I was. Okay, so Scottie has this big savior complex until she wants to throw a fit. Like, I think I mentioned this in the previous episode, but if my mom had cancer, I'm not going to be able to comfort anybody else in my family. I'm just going to be so distraught myself. He then cleared his throat and changed the subject completely. I think he was embarrassed about crying, but he shouldn't be. Your friend Stephanie looks nice, he smiled. She looks nice? That's like a really... He's a grown man complimenting a teenager on her looks. Of all the things he could have said about Stephanie, that's what he chose to say? That is weird. She is, I blushed. She's my partner for history. Ah, nice. Well, I got work to do, hon. What work? You're at home. You're a police officer. What could you possibly have to do in your office? I left his office smiling. Stephanie, Stephanie, Stephanie. I shook my head, still smiling, and then went outside to get fresh air. My neighbor Peter from school was outside too. Do we know Peter? Is this a character that already exists? Hi, how are you? He asked, dropping the hose. He was watering his garden. I'm all right, thanks, I sat on my porch. He came and sat next to me. Peter, oh, okay, we do know him. Peter was the one Jason didn't like because Peter had an obvious attraction to me. He never tried anything with me, though. Okay, but he did, like, pretty boldly approach you on your porch. Today he seemed a little off, not like himself. He wasn't even dressed as himself. Well, what does that mean? What does he normally dress like? We know nothing about Peter, so there's nothing to indicate to us that his behavior is off, because we don't fucking know this guy. I'm not thinking anything of it, because he's probably just trying to fit in and be accepted for once. That sounds really judgmental. I don't know why Scottie is so judgmental. I see you and Jason don't hang out as much. Was he stalking me? I laughed quietly to myself. No. Yeah, you see, right? I smiled. Do you just realize how much you'd rather have me? What? What kind of sentence is that? Do you just realize how much you'd rather have me? That has got to be the worst pickup line I have ever heard. The sentence barely even makes sense. I hope he was joking. Why was he acting more straightforward? That definitely wasn't the Peter I knew. I kind of just laughed and stood up. I'll see you later, Peter. He gave me a weird smile, then I went inside. The interaction I just had with him, I will erase from my mind. I wish I could erase all of Scottie from my mind, because this is terrible. And she just always introduces new plot points instead of building on old plot points. So we don't need Peter being weird. We don't need her mom's cancer. Like, build on the pregnancy and the hate crime, for God's sake. Stop introducing new plot points. Part 62. Melanie, Wendy, parentheses, Melanie's mom, and Jordan were coming over for dinner. Well, that's what Wendy, Jordan, Samantha, and my parents thought. Tonight was actually the night that everyone found out Mike got Melanie pregnant. Okay, well, they are coming over for dinner, right? They're just also getting this surprise announcement, so they're still coming over for dinner, just the purpose is not the same that they think it is. We were getting ready to set the table when they arrived, with a surprise guest, Mike. Her mom did not look happy. Her mom disliked Mike more than I did. Well, yeah, he sucks, and they tried to give him a redemption arc, and trust me, it did not work, at least not for me. Melanie gave me a hug and whispered, I hope you don't mind. She was talking about her bringing Mike. Well, yeah, he is the father of the baby, so it's kind of important that he's involved in this. I gave her an approving smile. I was glad he was here. He was the baby's father. Well, yeah, duh. Mike looked so much more put together. As everyone was greeting each other, I complimented him on that. He smiled and thanked me. So, it's so nice that Scottie went to his trailer, had one conversation with him, and now all of a sudden he's a changed man. All it took was Scottie talking to him one time, and now he's, like, ready to be here for this baby. This doesn't make any sense. Then there was Jordan. We both seemed a little distant from each other. Remember, Jordan tried to kiss Scottie, and Scottie blew her off. We did hug, so things weren't suspicious, and she told me she wanted to talk before they left, and I agreed. Then I hugged Wendy, thanking her for coming. We all sat in the living room talking about everything from the weather to Britney Spears. Why? To yesterday's breakfast. Who talks about their breakfast? How, like, this sounds like the most boring conversation on the planet. They're talking about the weather, Britney Spears, and breakfast. What a fucking, like, great conversation. Great dinner talk there. We were all having such a good time that I think Melanie forgot the real reason this get-together was happening. Well, didn't her mom, not Melanie's mom, Scottie's mom, already, like, look at Melanie and go, damn, you look pregnant, so I don't know why this is going to be a surprise to anybody. Finally, we were all sitting at the dinner table. She and I talked about when she should announce the news, and we decided before dinner. Everyone was having such a good time, even Wendy and Mike were getting along. I can tell she didn't want to ruin that when the time came. But we've got no indication that her mom is going to take this poorly, so I don't know why they're worried. She stood up, and then Mike stood up next to her. I'd like to say something, she looked at me worried. I smiled as a way of comforting her, but I knew this wouldn't go all that fantastic. Why won't it go fantastic? Tell us more information about how her mom is going to react, because I'm not getting the sense that anybody even gives a shit that she's pregnant. What are you doing, dear? Her mom said, obviously confused. My parents just smiled at Melanie, waiting to hear what she had to say. Also, this is weird. Do they frequently go to Scottie's parents' house for dinner? Is this like a one-time thing? Does this happen often? I just want to know. Mom, shh, please, Melanie told her mom. She slowly took off her sweatshirt, which has obviously been the disguise for her swollen belly. Is that obvious? We've never been told that she wears a sweatshirt. This is the first time. Now she stands in front of everyone in a tight pink spaghetti strap. What is up with Amber Lynn and spaghetti straps? Every fucking character in this book wears a spaghetti... Not a book. This is a poor excuse for a book, but... Why does everybody care... Every character wear a spaghetti strap? Now she stands in front of everyone in a tight pink spaghetti strap instead of a black sweatshirt that was two sizes too big. You could clearly see her belly. Holy shit, Jordan said, dropping her fork. Also, why is Jordan here? That doesn't make any sense that Jordan would be here. My parents looked from one another, then to Wendy, who was heading into the bathroom, already crying. Oh no, okay. Great, Mike muttered as Melanie jogged towards her mom. Everyone was clearly shocked besides me and Mike, since we knew. Did you know about this? My mother whispered in an angry voice. I nodded. Well, her mom, as I said, called Melanie out and said, you look pregnant. So, like, she didn't see this coming? Why didn't you tell us? Both my mom and dad said at the same time. I shrugged. It wasn't for me to tell them. I was the one pregnant. Okay, that's a very bad typo. It should be, I wasn't the one who was pregnant or something like that. Because I was the one pregnant is not even a sentence. And she means to say wasn't. This is not good. Okay. Wow, this is better than a soap opera, Samantha finally said something, and it made me want to strangle her. For the rest of dinner, we were all silent. Wendy looked all cried out. See, this is why you make the dramatic announcements after dinner, not before. Right after dinner, everyone left but Jordan. Well, even Stephanie and her parents, where did they go? Did they leave too? That sure was an interesting dinner, she said as we walked into my room. Sure was. I was glad it happened, though. Everybody needed to know, and plus, I saw my dad and Jordan getting along way better than I'd ever imagined. Yeah, right. Didn't they kick Jordan out of the house before, and they're like, never see Jordan again, and now all of a sudden they're totally cool with Jordan being around? Like, this, nothing makes sense at all, ever. I'm sorry, she finally said after a few minutes of silence. For what? I started folding my clean clothes to keep my mind preoccupied. She was sitting on the end of my bed, right where she almost kissed me. The other time we hung out, you know, she blushed. Oh, that was nothing. Don't worry about it. I was totally lying. I'm just confused about a lot. She acted like she didn't hear what I just said. So much is going on these days. Yeah, for us all. I felt bad for not acting like a friend and like I didn't care, so I went to go sit down next to her and ignored my laundry. I'm here for you always, Jordan, I said and placed my hand on her leg. Ooh, maybe don't do that. Maybe don't touch her. She put her hand on mine and stared at me right into my eyes. As am I, she smiled and then looked down. Looked down at what? Come on, Jordan. Everything will be okay, I promise. Yet again, I promised. Yeah, you just said promise. I put my hand under her chin and had a sudden burning urge. No! No! Don't do this. Don't fucking do this to me. Do not. She has a girlfriend in the fucking hospital. Do not make me do this. Don't make me read this. Ugh. I made her face me, then I leaned in to kiss her. No! Our lips slightly brushed one another, and I heard my sister yelling at me from outside my door. Thank God, Stephanie, to the rescue. Like, no. My problem with this is not that they're women. That is not my problem. My problem is that Jordan has a girlfriend. A sick girlfriend. Like, no. Open up. Damn, I need more printer paper. Why does Scottie have all the printer paper? She was banging on the door. She interrupted us for goddamn printer paper. Yeah, that's of all the things she could have came and asked for. She asked for printer paper. I got up, got the printer paper, and tossed it out the door as Jordan leaves. Again. Jordan, where are you going? I said, running, following down the stairs. I'll call you tomorrow. Then she left. Well, that was abrupt. Why did that happen twice? And why was I about to kiss a girl for the second time? Gee, I wonder. Help me pick up the damn papers, Samantha yelled from the top of the stairs. Fuck you, I yelled back. Okay. Well, that was dramatic. I really don't think we needed the Melanie pregnancy reveal in the same chapter as this Jordan kiss thing. Like, just pick one thing to happen in the chapter and focus on that. Like, okay. 63. It's lunchtime at school and out of my normal friends, I'm the only one at school. Okay. Normal friends? Okay. Vanessa was at the hospital, obviously. She had surgery today. What kind of surgery? Brain surgery? Did she break her arm? Like, just surgery? She wasn't allowed any visitors until she gets released on Sunday, and that's only if the surgery went right. What surgery? I don't even know why she needed surgery now that I think of it. What? Yeah, because you're a fucking doctor, Scottie. You would fucking know if somebody needs surgery. Stephanie was probably taking care of her mom, but I really missed her and wanted to know how she was doing. I wanted to see her beautiful face more than anything, just be near her. It was such a new, amazing feeling. Jason, I had no idea about. So break up with him, girl. Just dump him and get it over with. Me and him have drifted so apart from each other, I didn't care where he was. Melanie was probably home puking her lungs out. Does Amber Lynn think that when you're pregnant, you just throw up constantly? Because some people probably do, to be fair, but not everybody. Poor girl, but it was all worth the miracle at the end. Is it, though? Because Wendy, her mom, like, clearly is pissed about this, and Mike lives in a trailer, so how's he going to support the baby? So I don't know that I would call this a miracle. I wonder what happened after she left my house last night. Well, maybe if you were true friends, you would have called her and figured it out. Jordan was probably embarrassed about last night or something along those lines. I hope everyone gets back to somewhat normal soon. Well, you were the one who tried to kiss Jordan that time, so that's your fault if she's embarrassed, and you're a bad friend. 64. Online. Oh, another online conversation. I fucking hate these. Stephanie, how are you feeling? My mom just got out of the hospital today. Out of the hospital for having an anxiety attack? I'm pretty sure that's why she was there before. Yay, Stephanie. Scotty, hi. Smiley face. I'm better. Thanks. I hope your mom is too. How are you? Stephanie, I'm good now, heart. Yes, my mom's good. Thanks. Did Stephanie like girls? How would I find out? Why do I care so much? Was I starting to like girls? Well, you did try to kiss one the other day. Just, Scotty's, I know sexuality is hard. That takes time to figure out. But Scotty is just so obtuse. Like, what? Okay. Scotty, you're welcome, smiley face. Stephanie, would you like to come over Saturday? Well, I mean, they need to work on that history project, so. My heart started pounding really fast. She wanted to hang out. I'd love to, smiley face. We need to start that history project, haha. Ugh. Yeah, I know. We will have fun, smiley face. There goes my heart again. I bet we will, heart. What is up? Okay, why are there so many hearts and smiley faces? Like, when I was on Instant Messenger back in the day, I don't remember putting hearts and smiley faces that constantly. Was I flirting? Was she? No way, just being friends. Stephanie, I gotta go. See you at school, heart, smiley face. Scotty, bye, smiley face, heart. It was sad to say bye. I wanted to keep talking to her. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it more than most of anything, oddly. Why is that odd? You're clearly interested in her. Oh my goodness. Okay, well, hopefully that meeting goes well on Saturday. Whatever. I don't even know what day it is supposed to be in the narrative. 65. Hello. Hi, Melanie. I decided to call her. I wanted to see if she was okay, if everything was okay. Well, it took you long enough. You should have called her when she went home. Hey, Scotty, what's up? She sounded happy. I wanted to know if everything was okay with... She interrupted. Yes, yes. She had excitement in her voice. Me and Mike and my mom are going baby shopping tomorrow. What are they going to buy? Babies? Like, that's just a weird phrase. Everything is perfect. I was thrilled for her. I'm so happy for you. We talked some more about everything going on. Yet again, didn't bring up Jordan or Stephanie. Okay. So if Wendy was upset to the point that she, like, stormed out of dinner and was crying, why is everything okay all of a sudden? Like, I want to know more about the pregnancy. I don't want to know about, like, her mom's cancer. Or, like, just pick one plot point and stick with it. 66. Jordan hasn't called like she said she was going to. Well, yeah, you tried to kiss her. I'm not going to call her because I don't want to seem desperate or anything like that. I'll just wait for her to call me. Again, what a good friend. Jordan is clearly struggling and her girlfriend is in the hospital and it just seems like Scotty totally forgot about all of that. I really don't understand why I'm feeling the way I do about Stephanie and Jordan. I don't understand why the things that are happening, period. Me neither. Why did I want to kiss Jordan? Why did I want to constantly be near and be talking to Stephanie? Am I a lesbian? Yeah, probably. No, I can't be. I've had two boyfriends. Girl, that is not how that works. Everybody, just because you've dated a guy doesn't mean that you can't be a lesbian. Like, if anybody's watching this and is struggling with that, you're totally fine. You can be a lesbian if you've dated men before. My parents disagree with that type of stuff. Well, yeah, they kicked Jordan out of your house and now they're suddenly totally fine with her, which, again, was a plot point that was never resolved. They'd kill me if I was, but I'm not, so they won't kill me. So everything will be okay. But why didn't I believe that? Well, will they literally kill her? Because some families will literally kill you for that. 67. Again, nobody was at school yet again, but besides Stephanie and Jason. Me and Stephanie talked a little, but I wish we would have talked more. It was in first period. Hey, Stephanie, I whispered. She was sitting in front of me. Yeah, she turned around. We were working on some assignment to where we had to write about a what? What the fuck? I'm so sorry. We were working on some assignment to where we had to write about a remembering experience in our lives, and the teacher was the only one who was allowed to read it just in case it was too personal. What? Usually the teacher is the only one that reads assignments anyway. And also, remembering experience? Does she mean memory? Is the word she's looking for memory? What the fuck is going on? I was writing about how I found out my mom had cancer. That would never leave my mind. There's not a chance I would write about something like that for a school assignment, because I would just be sitting at my desk crying. There's not a chance I would write about that. Not a chance. What are you writing about? I asked, making an excuse to talk to her and see her beautiful green eyes. Are the teachers just fine with them talking in the middle of class while people are trying to work on this assignment? I don't know yet. She blushed, then turned to face forward again. I quietly, slightly looked over my shoulder, and she had a full page done. Why'd she lie to me? How do you quietly look over your shoulder? Like, does your neck crack when you turn your head? How is that quiet or not quiet? Why did she? I sit here at lunch with Jason, not talking, my mind wandering. Okay, well, it's a good thing we teleported from the classroom to lunch. That's totally good. He finally speaks up. Do you want your fries? Oh, God. No, have them, I snapped. Geez, sorry, he took them anyway. No, I'm sorry, Jason, I didn't mean to snap. I really didn't. Don't be sorry, you're going through a lot, I understand. He used to always understand. I hate when people say, I understand. Well, does your mom have cancer? No, then you don't understand. I hate that. I smiled, thanks. But Scotty, his face went from warm to scared looking. Things have changed. Yeah, and? Was he breaking up with me? You should break up with him, girl. This conversation's long overdue. We don't click like we used to. Shouldn't I be saying these things? Yeah, you had every chance in the world to say these things. You just chose not to. Oh, I didn't expect to hurt like that. I didn't expect this to hurt like it was. See, but Scottie has repeatedly said that she doesn't care about Jason. She doesn't think about Jason. Doesn't even care where he is or what he's doing. So I think she's just more hurt that she is being dumped, not because she's losing Jason. And honestly, that's like a really narcissistic, terrible thing to just be mad that somebody broke up with you, not because you actually miss them as a person. We should just be friends, Scotty. I found someone else. Yes, your little sister, what's her face? Not Stephanie, that's the Samantha. Ouch, that was harsh. Who is it? I had tears in my eyes. I felt like our friendship we used to have also wouldn't be there anymore. Well, you guys were not really friends. Like, okay. Also, how does Scotty not realize it's Samantha that he's talking about? Because she has noticed before that they were flirting a lot and pouted over it. Jason also specifically came to their house to hang out with Samantha that one time. So I don't understand how Scotty is not putting these pieces together. It doesn't matter, he said, standing to leave. I'm sorry I hurt you. Then he walked away. I was so surprised. I didn't know what to do besides cry. Yes, that's what I wanted, but it still hurt. I thought I was going to be the one breaking up with him, but I prolonged it. See, she is only upset because she wasn't the one who did the dumping. She was the dumpy. I guess I knew in my instincts that it would hurt, even if it was the right thing to do. Also, what a douche move to do that at school. Like, do that at home. Don't make her cry during school. That's rude. 68. That was an awkward ride home. Jason's still giving her rides home? Jason didn't say one word at all. Neither did I. As soon as I got home, I see Jordan sitting on my porch steps. But Jordan didn't even go to school, according to the last chapter. What are you doing here? I asked, sitting down next to her since she didn't get up. Just wanted to come by and say hi. She had an unusual smile on her face. Vanessa's surgery. What surgery? Went well. I'm glad. I was worrying about that. Were you? Because I didn't think you were. I called her room earlier and apologized for how I acted the other day. I smiled. I wonder if she told Vanessa the truth yet. I guess she could tell by the look on my face because she says, I haven't told her. I just told her that me and her were good friends. She wants to hang out. She now sounded excited. She actually asked me to hang out. She then blushed. I had a feeling she might get hurt, and I didn't want that. Why are they acting that just because Vanessa has amnesia that she's going to be, like, homophobic or something all of a sudden? I don't understand why they can't just be honest with her about who Jordan is. Like, I have gotten no sense as to why they can't just tell her what is going on. Jordan, you have to understand that she doesn't even know she's a lesbian. I felt bad to have burst her bubble. Again, why does it matter? Why is it such a big deal to be a lesbian? I don't think that's a big deal. I know. She took a deep breath. I need to work my magic or something. Ugh, what the fuck does that mean? Don't do anything you're gonna regret. I had no idea what she was planning. Don't worry about me, she smiled. Well, I'm gonna go inside. Come with me unless you have to leave, I said, standing up. It felt good knowing I can just invite Jordan in whenever. I used to never be able to do that. And we're gonna get no explanation as to what changed to cause her parents to allow Jordan to stay over. I don't have to leave, she followed me into the house. I'm gonna go to the bathroom, okay? I went to my room as she went to the opposite direction and came back sooner than I expected. Your sister's in the bathroom. I will check in a few minutes. Okay, well, why couldn't she just go to the bathroom? That was like, it's She just always adds these weird-ass details into her stories. Okay, I giggled. So what do you want to do? Play a game. I don't know, she laughed. Okay, but they're not going to address the kiss? We ended up watching a movie, 50 First Dates. Halfway through, she went to go use the bathroom. It took her a whole ass hour, or I don't know how long 50 First Dates is, but at least 30 minutes for her to try to go use the bathroom again. But Samantha was still in there. Why? Did Samantha take some mean shits or something? Why is Samantha still in the bathroom? What the hell was she doing in there? Jordan just used my parents' bathroom. Oh, I know what's going to happen. I think that maybe Samantha is also pregnant and she was taking a pregnancy test. Okay, I'm calling it. Samantha's also pregnant with Jason's baby. I wonder what she is doing, Jordan said. What the fuck? She probably just found out what an orgasm feels like? She laughed. Okay, what? Samantha is 14. I don't want to think about a 14-year-old, orgasming. What? What about Samantha being in the bathroom makes them think she's in there masturbating? Like, what the fuck? I have no words, guys. I'm, like, shook as hell by that. Ew, that's not what I want envisioned in my mind. Me neither. I got a pillow and hit her with it. Bad idea, because she got a bigger pillow and hit me hard enough to where it didn't hurt but knocked me down on my bed. I playfully kicked her. It must have been a little too hard because she came tumbling down right after me, then out of nowhere she kissed me. What? If you kick somebody, they're gonna fall away from you. How would they fall forward on top of you if you kicked them? Also, they're kissing? Tongue and all. Why? We kept kissing. It felt good. I got a fire feeling through my body and a tingle feeling too. We were kissing kind of fast and getting into it. Me on top of her. How did she get on top of what's her face? If she what? I don't understand the logistics of what's happening here. Then she stopped and pushed me off of her. We both laid there, no words, only the sound of my heart pounding in my ear. Okay. So Jordan was just very excited about Vanessa asking her to hang out, and it seemed like things were going to go well with that relationship, and they're just going to fucking ruin it by doing that. Like, I have no sympathy for people who fuck around on their partners. If you want to go fuck around with someone else, that's totally fine. Break up with the current person first. 69. Oh, sorry. 639. We're going to try to read to 70, and then we're going to be done, because holy shit, guys, this one was a real doozy. Where's your sister? Said my dad, coming into my room without knocking. He looked angry. Well, if he'd just come a little bit sooner, he would have saw some action. She's been in the bathroom for God knows how long. I got up from the computer. I was doing homework ever since Jordan left. Okay, so we're just going to flash forward. How many hours has it been? Like, has her sister been in the bathroom this whole time? What the fuck's going on? I was trying to keep my mind off of what happened. What'd she do wrong? I followed him to the bathroom. Samantha Leanna Farrell. Her middle name's Leanna? Get your butt out of that bathroom. He looked at me. I hope you're not her influence. Geez, what did I do? She got him so mad. Samantha slowly opened the door. She had dark brown hair. Okay, so she was just in there dyeing her hair. So my pregnancy thing is out of the water. That theory is busted. She did have blonde. I looked at her utterly shocked. My dad went from mad to laughing uncontrollably. What was so funny? His 14-year-old daughter just dyed her damn hair. Why was I so mad all of a sudden? I've dyed my hair many, many, many times. And I can tell you it does not take hours and hours. Especially if you already have blonde hair and you're just putting brown dye over it. It takes like at most 45 minutes to fully put the dye in your hair. You let it sit for another 45 minutes and then you wash that shit out. Like 2 hours tops. And it seems like she's been in there all day. Hi, Daddy, she put on the best puppy dog face. Do you like my hair? She looked at him confused, as did I. Why did you dye your hair? He asked between laughs. I wanted to look more like Scottie, Daddy, she said, looking at me. That'd take forever to pull off, I thought. Well, that was conceited. Also, okay, is she trying to look more like Scottie because that's what Jason wants? Because that would be really creepy. Our dad suddenly stopped laughing. That's nice of you, dear, but you should have asked first. Why was he letting this slide? Now he suddenly got serious. Why weren't you at school yesterday? What? So Samantha is also skipping school? I feel like a cop would not be okay with his daughters constantly skipping school. I'm sorry, Daddy. Why does she keep saying Daddy? That's so weird. She gave puppy dog eyes again, but this time it didn't work. You're grounded, Samantha. He then went back downstairs. She looked at me and rolled her eyes and stormed off to her room. Why is she trying to be like me? I bet it's for Jason. 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 Oh my gosh, J- Jason wasn't at school yesterday either, that little brat. She was with Jason. I'm definitely not her influencer. I wouldn't be that dumb. Okay, so she finally put the pieces together that Jason and Samantha are together. But we're not getting any, like, it just ends. It just ends before we know her actual feelings on this. She just ends things too soon. 70. This is going to be the last part because, oh my god, guys. I'm supposed to go to Stephanie's today, but I can't. Not because I can't, but because I am scared. I am scared of the feelings I get when I am around her. I have never felt such feelings before. Well, you probably felt them for Jordan when you had your tongue in her mouth. I have never wanted to constantly talk and be near someone so much all of my life until I met Stephanie. For all of my life, I have been kind of distant from people. You have a lot of friends, so I don't know that to be true. I'm popular at school, but I only let myself be friends with a few people, and the few people I have chosen, I am grateful for. Well, she's popular at school? Because I've not gotten that sense at all. I usually never let people know my feelings, except for my few close friends. Except you haven't told Melanie, your best friend, anything about any of what you're feeling. I barely knew Stephanie, but I wanted to let her in more than anything or anyone, but I was too scared of this feeling. I decided to call her and cancel. So you're just not going to work on this history project then? Because that's what she invited you over. She didn't invite you over to hang out. She wants to work on your project. Hello, a woman answered, most likely her mom. Hi, is Stephanie there? May I ask who is calling? She seemed like such a sweet lady. For what? Just asking a question? It's Scottie. I'm a friend from school. Oh yes, it's nice to finally hear your voice. I've heard a lot about you. Why? It's not like Stephanie and Scottie really interact that much. She has? I blushed. Stephanie has been talking about me. I wonder what she has said. Yeah, that's me, Scottie. I hope I didn't sound stupid. I can't wait to meet you today. Great, now I was going to let down her mother. Well, I'll get Stephanie. Bye for now. Gosh, she seemed nice. Bye, I smiled nervously, but she couldn't see it. Yeah, because you're on the phone. You don't need to tell me that she can't see you smiling nervously when you're on the phone with her. I understand that. I know she can't see you. I waited for a little longer than I expected. Then there was that sweet voice. Hi, Scottie. She sounded happy. I'd soon shatter that. You canceling a meeting is going to make her, like, shatter her? Scottie just has, like, a lot of self-importance. Hi, Stephanie. How would this work? I'm sick? I don't want to lie, but I sure can't be honest in this situation. What time do you plan on coming over? She had anxiousness on her voice. So it's the day of, and they don't even have a time picked? Because I for sure would have a time picked in advance. I can't come over today, I'm sorry. I really was. There was a silence. Oh, it's okay, I understand, she finally said. You knew she didn't understand because I didn't even give her a reason for my absence. I felt horrible. What's up with the sudden second person? You knew she didn't understand. How about I knew she didn't understand? Not you knew. Stephanie, it's not what you think. She probably thought it was because of who she was. I was. What? What the fuck does that mean? People like her didn't talk to people like me. What the fuck are you talking about? Because you're popular and she's fat? Just because she's fat, people can't like her? Like, that is so weird coming from Amber Lynn, who is a big person herself. Like, that is such a weird thing to write. But who made that rule? I sure in the hell didn't. I wanted to talk to her, but she didn't know that. I was probably rotten to her. But would people really make fun of Scottie for hanging out with Stephanie if they had a project to work on? Because they have a legitimate reason to be together to work on this project, and people are going to make fun of them for that? Like, I know high schoolers suck, but I don't think they suck that much. Yeah, actually, I think it is. Then she hung up. God, what did I do? I started crying, tears pouring down like a storm on my face. Is it really that serious? I really needed someone to talk to. I couldn't talk to Jordan. She and I kissed. Okay, what the fuck does that mean? You can't talk to her? Like, and we don't even know how that situation resolved. I couldn't talk to Melanie. She wouldn't understand. Why wouldn't she understand? What wouldn't she understand about that? She's had her own relationship problems. I couldn't talk to Vanessa. She has her own problems. Yeah, she's a fucking amnesiac who just got out. Again, I don't know if amnesiac's a word, but you know what I mean. And she just got out of surgery. Don't bother Vanessa with your petty bullshit. I couldn't talk to Samantha. She is as immature as a 9-year-old. I don't know that that is true. I couldn't talk to my parents. They would kick me out. I couldn't talk to Stephanie. She was my problem. I decided to write my Uncle Tim a letter. Remember, that's like her gay uncle that her father refuses to speak to. I needed him. This letter will be hard to write. Me and him were not as close as I wish we were because of my dad. I'll send it right when I am done. Here I go, I thought. Dear Uncle Tim, guess who? Yes, it'd be your niece Scottie. How are you doing? How is Mark, Kathy, and Michelle? I'm missing all of you. I just wanted to write you something short. I need your help. I'm sorry for being so blunt, but it's true. I'd love to hear from you. Sincerely, Scottie. But if you're going to go through all the trouble of sending a letter, wouldn't you describe the problem in the letter? Because now she's going to have to wait for him to write her a letter, and then she's going to have to write another letter explaining the situation, and then he's going to have to write another letter giving her advice. It just seems like prolonging the process to not just write everything in the first letter. But that's where we're going to leave it for this part, because my brain is melting. See you next time, guys.